It's our Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1619, offset for a VLOOKUP table. Now, today's question is sent in by Ron. Ron's trying to figure out when you would ever use offset in conjunction with VLOOKUP. And one example that I have, I've seen this before. You know, we have account or cost centers in accounting, and sometimes there's multiple companies. So there's company 100, company 200, company 300, and based on whichever company is entered here, we want to go use a different VLOOKUP table. All right, so the offset function is very, very flexible. It says, you know, hey, we're going to start from a particular cell. In this case, it's going to start from B1. And then how many rows down from there do we go to find the start of the lookup table? So if this says 100, we're going to go down one row. But if it says 200, then we're going to go down 8 rows. So we're going to fill in that number of rows down. For the number of columns to the right, well, that's just going to be hard-coded to 0. We're not going to move any columns to the right to get to the top left corner cell of the range. But then the height and width of the range, well, the width in this case I know is just 2, but the height is going to be different every time. All right, so we need to be able to fill in those two question marks there. Where does this company start? Equal match. Match of the 200, comma, and we'll start here in A2 and go down. And we want an exact match. All right, so that tells us that the 200s, see, it doesn't start in row 8, it starts in the 8th row of that range. So when we start here in B1 and we go down 8 cells, we'll get to the top left-hand corner cell. All right, how many rows for this company? Equal COUNTIF, count how many times in column A we have 200. And it'll say that for company 200, it is 6 rows. If we ask for row, company 100, 7 rows. All right, so it's going to be a different number of rows every single time. So kind of just practicing here, equal offset from B1, press F4, comma, the number of rows down is going to be this answer, comma, the number of columns is 0, the height is this answer, and the width is 2. All right, so we have that whole little formula fragment there. I'm going to copy that, Control C to copy. We'll press Escape, and up here in our VLOOKUP, I'm going to paste that formula fragment right there for the lookup table. For the lookup table, and at this point, I can get rid of that apostrophe. And so, company 200, account center 1050, 2048. We'll try company 100. And account center 1030 gets the 4, all right, so it's actually working. At this point now, we can make one super mega formula. So here in F7, we have those characters. I'll copy those from the formula bar, and then I'll do the same thing for F10 to end up with a really, really large, unwieldy formula. I always build these in pieces at first, just so that way I can break it down into the component parts. And then you can put it all back together if you would like at the end. Here, let's get that so we can see the whole formula here in our expanding formula bar. That's a confusing thing. But hopefully, with this explanation here, you know, we're trying to figure out where the company starts, how many rows for the company, putting that into the offset, and then using that offset as the table range in our VLOOKUP. I want to thank Ron for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time on the Netcast from Mr. Excel.